Okay, guys, this is the moment you've all been waiting for. We have taken over the awesome Star Wars theme Pioneer DJ booth here at NAMM 2016. I'm talking with Mark, and he's going to take us through the paces on the brand new CDJ-2000NXS2 unit. Tell us a little bit about this, Mark.
All right, let's briefly go over all these features here. The first thing I can't actually show you, but I can tell you about, is the sound quality improvement. That's really one of the things that we strive for in this mixer and in the CDJ combo, and we knocked it out of the park, if I don't say so myself. The mixer outputs full digital, 96K, 24-bit. The mixer can take in 96K, 24-bit, and also output 96K, 24-bit by a spit-in. So it's a fully digital mixer, and the sound quality is much richer, warmer, and clearer than its predecessor, the DJM 900 Nexus. We were really striving for that warmer, richer sound, and we definitely achieved it. We blind tested it with a lot of the top sound guys in the country, and they couldn't even tell the difference between some of the competition and our 900 Nexus 2. So let's start with features. Let's jump to the player here in the top left corner. You're gonna first notice here, four hot cue buttons instead of three, and we have two banks, so you have a total of eight hot cues. The colors here come from Record Box, so you could change your hot cue pad color in Record Box, and that will be reflected here. Recording hot cues is also different. So now it's just a one-touch process to record, and one touch again to launch. To delete, just hold this button and delete. You can see a slip reverse switch here, which is a momentary slip reverse switch. We brought back our 4-beat loop, which if you hold down for 2 seconds, gives you an 8-beat loop. And then every time you touch it there, cuts it in half. This is a full 7-inch touchscreen here, which you can see can showcase a full RGB waveform. You can jump back and forth between our old phase meter here with the four blocks and our new phase meter there with the lines. Makes it a little bit easier to line up tracks. We have beat jump here, one beat in either direction. Loop mode, which enables you to quickly tap loops in and exit out. This is one of our little magic button here called the shortcut button, this button here. You touch that one time and it brings up this window. In this window, you can select a couple different things. Again, with your phase meter here, you can change your hot cue auto load settings. You can either turn them on or off or have them coincide with your Record Box preset settings. You can change your quantized beat value from one beat to a half beat, quarter beat, or eighth beat. One of the coolest things here, full QWERTY keyboard search. That's huge. A lot of DJs were asking for this for a long time, and we incorporated it here. Here I'm going to jump into track filter. This is our track filter settings. What this enables you to do is really perfectly locate the songs that you're looking for. So let's say you're playing a long set, and you're looking for tracks that are plus or minus 6% of 130 beats per minute. And you could change all this, let's say 128. Plus or minus 3% of 128 beats per minute in the key of C, there's all your keys, or related, with a rating of 3 stars, or 2 stars, or 4 stars, with a color of pink, red, and orange. And all those tracks that are tagged with that criteria within Record Box will show up. You can dig even further with our My Tag feature. So components may include, but are not limited to, synth, sub bass, dark, percussive, piano, vocal. You can add anything you want here within Record Box, and then go back and select your criteria accordingly. Situation, build up, peak time, after hours, warm up tracks, pool parties, anything you can think of. Again, all this is customizable within Record Box. Whatever makes it easier for you to dig through your tracks or tag your tracks and for you to be able to find them. Let's jump right over to the mixer. First thing you'll notice here, two sound cards, A and B, which is perfect for handing off between two DJs or two DJs playing back to back. We added a parameter knob to our sound color effects, which gives you a little bit more control over those effects, allowing you to customize them. The color effects knobs are slightly larger for a better grip and better feel. Moving down, you can see our second headphone jack. We have a second headphone output that's an eighth inch jack, just in case you forget your quarter inch adapter or lose it on the plane, like so many DJs have. You can also hook up two pairs of headphones at the same time for those of you playing back to back. There are four phono inputs on the mixer, one on each channel. What we added here was a clip light. So for DJs who are playing a bit too loud, this gives you a good warning to turn it down. Sound guys are really going to appreciate that one. Moving on down, we changed the crossover point of the low EQ knob, so you're going to cut out less of the mids when cutting out all of the lows. Our beat effects lighting here will show you which channel the beat effects are going to be applied to. Moving over to the right here, we added this middle feature here on the crossfade, on the channel fader. Acts more like a rotary mixer for doing really, really long, gradual mixes. Beat effects. We added a ping pong delay. We brought back the pitch. We added a vinyl break, and we added a helix effect. James Nabila does a really good job of demonstrating this in our product release video on PioneerDJ.com. You can check that out. Another cool feature here, effects frequency selector buttons enables you to determine which frequencies you want affected. So if you're doing a ping pong delay, you probably don't want to affect the low end. So we'll deselect that and only apply that ping pong effect to the mids and highs, which is really cool. Moving up, we doubled our the size of our X pad, enabling you to quickly change the timing of the beat effect. Moving even further up, we completely removed our send and return section from the bottom and moved it up here. So now it's separate. In the past, you could either be applying beat effects or you could be using the send and return. You couldn't do both. Now you can. By switching this here, you're utilizing your quarter inch send and return jacks on the back. By switching it to the right, you are now utilizing your industry first digital send and return via USB. So what this is doing right now is, if you want to zoom out a little bit and get our iPad app. This is the RMX 1000 iPad app. So you can actually utilize this just as if it were an external unit. So now it's not only exclusive to the RMX app. You could use any type of app, such as a guitar pedal type of effect, or anything that sends audio through the Lightning port. That is our digital send and return. That pretty much sums up the Nexus 2 system. As you can see, it's a lot of new features incorporated here. And again, I can't stress enough, the sound quality was really our number one goal, our number one priority. And we definitely achieved it here with this setup.
Mark, thank you very much. It's been great. Thank you.